Welcome to Everyday Cooking. If you haven't subscribed the channel yet, please click the subscribe button and the bell icon to stay connected, and it is absolutely free.
Today let us see how to prepare instant tomato dosa. For this, take 2 chopped tomatoes in a mixy jar. To this add 2 garlic cloves and a small piece of ginger. Grind this into a fine paste. The tomato paste is ready, let us transfer this into another bowl. To this add 1/4 cup of onions, few chopped coriander leaves, few chopped curry leaves, 1 teaspoon of cumin seeds, 2 tablespoons of curd, 1/2 cup of rice flour, 1/2 cup of rava, that is suji or semolina, 2 tablespoons of wheat flour and required amount of salt. Mix everything together. Now let us add enough water to make this a loose batter. The batter has to be like this. Let this rest for another 10 minutes. After 10 minutes, you can add around 1 teaspoon of Kashmiri chili powder. You can also use normal chili powder. If so, you can use 1/2 teaspoon of it. This is the batter consistency, please note it. Now spread this on a hot tawa. You should pour it like this, you should not press and spread this. Let us add some oil or ghee. Close it with the lid and cook this until it is ready. Our tomato dosa is ready. You don't need to flip this. You can take it out as it is. This will be very, very crispy and will taste so, so good. Sambar or any chutney will be a best combination for this dosa. Next, we are going to do a roti with rice flour. Take 1/4 cup of groundnuts, dry roast them. The groundnuts are ready, let this cool down. Once it cools down, remove the skin and grind it coarsely. Set this aside. Now take 2 cups of rice flour. To this add 1 or 2 chopped green or red chilies, 1/2 cup of chopped onions, few chopped coriander leaves, 1/2 cup chopped curry leaves, coarsely grinded groundnuts, 1/2 cup required amount of salt, 1/2 cup and finally 1/2 cup required amount of water. You have to make a little loose dough out of this. So add water little by little and mix this carefully. The dough has to be like this. This should neither be a batter nor a thick dough. Now take a wet cloth. Don't let the cloth get dry. Only when the cloth is wet, the dough won't stick onto it. Whenever necessary, you can sprinkle some water like this. Now take a small ball out of the dough, spread this evenly and as thin as possible. This is ready. Now spread some oil on the tawa. Pick the flattened dough along with the cloth and drop it carefully on the tawa. Now turn this and cook properly. Turn both sides and cook this until it is crispy. The roti is ready. This will taste so good when it is hot. Next, let us see a dosa with leftover cooked rice and rice flour. For this, take a cup of cooked rice. To this, add a quarter cup of rice flour, a quarter cup of curd, and the required amount of salt. Let us grind this once before adding water. By this way, you can grind this properly without any lumps. This is ready. Now add the required amount of water. Now grind this to get a smooth batter. The batter is ready. It has to be free flowing like this. To this, let us add 2 tablespoons of suji, that is rava. And finally, a quarter teaspoon of baking soda. Mix this well, and before preparing dosa, let this rest for 5 or 10 minutes. The batter is ready. It has to be like this. Now let us prepare dosa. Now spread this very gently. You have used cooked rice, so this batter will be little sticky, so don't press. Be gentle while spreading. Spread some oil. Let us close this and cook one side. This is ready. Now turn it and cook until it is lightly brown and crispy. Here our dosa is ready. Like regular dosa, you can have this with some sambar or chutney. Plain onion sambar, coconut chutney or tomato chutney will be very nice for this. Next is a Sri Lankan recipe, lavaria. First, let us get ready with the stuffing. And for the stuffing, we need half a cup of split green gram, that is moong dal. Clean it with water and add a cup of water. So we are going to keep it on the flame until it is soft. The dal has become very soft. It is cooked well. Set this aside, and our next step is melting the jaggery. Take 1 cup of jaggery. To this, add 1/4 cup of water. Keep it on the flame until the jaggery completely melts. The jaggery is ready. Set this aside. Now in a pan, add the cooked dal. To this, add 1/2 cup of grated coconut. Filter and add the melted jaggery. Jaggery will have some impurities, so filtering is must. Now start stirring. You have to stir this until it is thick. You can stir this occasionally, but don't let it sit down and stick to the pan. This is thick and perfect. This will become even more thick when it cools down. Next, for the outer layer, take 1 cup of rice flour. To this, add the required amount of salt and a teaspoon of oil and give a nice mix. Add hot water little by little and make a soft dough out of this. When the heat is bearable, you can use your hands. the dough is still sticky, apply some oil on your hands and then knead it. Here the dough is soft and ready. For the next step, you need a butter paper or a plastic sheet or a banana leaf. Grease the sheet with oil and take your idiyappam maker. You can use your chakli maker or any type of idiyappam maker. Now take some dough and fill it in the idiyappam maker. Now press it like this. So our outer coating is ready. Now place a tablespoon of stuffing in the middle. Bring the sides to the center and close this. If you want, you can cut the edges, or otherwise you can leave it. So this is ready for steaming. Let us place this in the steamer. For steaming, I am going to use an idli steamer, and you can use any type of steamer. Cook this for about 10 minutes. This is ready, we can take it out. So here if you have some bread and rice flour, you can do this bread dosa. For this I am going to take 5 slices of bread. Here I am using whole wheat and grain bread. Don't need to go for any specific bread for this, you can use any kind of bread. Now add the bread into the mixing jar and powder it. Powder it as fine as possible. This is ready, now let us transfer this into another bowl. To this add 1/3 cup of rice flour, 2 tablespoons of basil flour, that is gram flour, 1/4 cup of curd, the required amount of salt and 1/2 teaspoon of baking soda. If you are more health conscious and want to avoid baking soda, you can always avoid it. Baking soda will give a little softness to the batter, but it doesn't make much difference. Add enough water and make a loose batter. You can use this batter as it is to prepare dosa. When you add a little tempering, the dosa will taste so good. So next is the tempering. Pour some oil in a pan. To this add 1/2 teaspoon of mustard seeds and 1/2 teaspoon of split black gram, that is urad dal. Once the mustard starts popping, add few curry leaves, extra teaspoon of cumin seeds, finally 1/4 cup of chopped onions. Fry the onions well until it is translucent. Tempering is ready, now let us add this into the dosa batter. Give a nice mix. Have a look at the batter has to be in this consistency. Spread the batter in a hot greased tawa. Spread enough oil. Turn both sides and cook properly. Our dosa is ready, we can take it out now. Any type of chutney and a sambar would be a great combination for this dosa. Next, let us see an easy to do sweet breakfast recipe, Bapa Pitta. For this, take 1 cup of rice flour. Add some water little by little and crumble it. The final consistency has to be like this. When you press it, it has to form a shape, and when you crumble it, it has to crumble like this. Rice flour is ready, next is jaggery. To easily powder the jaggery, use a microwave. First, let us microwave this for 30 seconds. After 30 seconds, take it out, flip it and microwave it again for 30 seconds. You can see that this has become soft. Use a spoon or a potato smasher or even your hand to powder this. So here our jaggery powder is ready. Other than this, we need some scrapped coconut. Now take a bowl, fill half of it with the rice flour. Give a light press, don't press it so hard. Next, let us top this with some coconut. After the coconut, top this with some powdered jaggery. Finally, close this with some rice flour. Seal this properly with the rice flour. I'm going to use an idli steamer to steam this, so I'm going to transfer this into an idli plate. This is idli steamer, I have already filled water. Steam cook this for 8 to 10 minutes. The Bapa Pitta is ready, we can take it out now. Bapa Pitta is ready. Next, we are going to prepare puttu, and with the puttu, we are going to do puttu upma. For the puttu, take 3 by 4 cup of rice flour.
To this, add a pinch of salt. Now sprinkle some water little by little and mix well. Add enough water to crumble it. You should not make it into a dough. This is ready. You have to get this consistency. Next, let us steam this. If you have a puttu maker, you can very well use that. Otherwise, you can use an idli maker or any other steamer. Now, I'm going to use idli maker. So, I have taken a tumbler and I have added grated coconut. Next, we have to fill the rice flour. This has to get set, so press this lightly. Transfer this into an idli stand. Everything is full and ready to be steamed, and we are going to steam this for around 10 to 15 minutes. This is also a recipe. This is called puttu. You can serve the puttu with some chickpea curry or bananas. It will be very nice. This is ready. We can take it out now. Next, let us use a puttu maker to steam this. Fill the water in your puttu maker. Get ready with that. Now fill the grated coconut. And now the prepared rice mix. So fill this and steam for around 15 to 20 minutes. This is also ready. We can take it out. I'm going to use half of it for making upma. This has to get cooled down completely. Now crumble this. This is ready. Set this aside. Pour some oil in a pan. To this, add half a teaspoon of mustard seeds, half a teaspoon of urad dal, and half a teaspoon of chana dal. Let the mustards pop and the dal changes its color. Now add 1/4 cup of chopped onions. After the onions are translucent, add dry chilies, 2 or 3 dry chilies according to your taste, and a handful of curry leaves. Add the required amount of salt. And finally, the crumbled rice flour. You can saute this for around 2 to 3 minutes. Our rice upma is ready. Let us transfer this into another plate. Our rice upma or puttu upma is ready. Hope you like it. We'll join you in another interesting recipe, and don't forget to subscribe our channel.